So this is from a whole cycle. We talked about the points that need to be controlled for data security. You see, after he finished talking about destruction, he went back to what is the appropriate preservation. So let's take a look at the appropriate preservation. That is, where does my data actually exist? We just mentioned that from the perspective of cloud data destruction, the data in the cloud may have the highest risk. Actually, it's like this. Because why? Because as for preserving data, we first need to understand the data. Where does it actually exist? And its classification, because it's like this, where the data is actually stored is determined by the level of the data. For example, top secret data, we may not only need to provide its security on the new system, but also the physical security is still very high. For example, like top secret data, it could be like a company's formula or some important financial information that might have to be kept in a bank vault because it's the safest. Physical security is also very important, but some data is not very secure. For example, like log data, that might just be for archiving. So I put it in an offline data, even if it's put on a tape, or put it in that CD library is okay. No need for encryption. So the policy of storage or the strategy of storage, it's actually related to the data classification we talked about before. And the frequency of business use of this data, they are all related. So it's more important to figure out where the data exists. Of course, in the process of defining where the data exists, we also need to consider the stakeholders, their interest needs. For example, I need to look at this data often. It's transaction data. Then we might just put it in this SAN or NAS. It's online storage if this data itself is business level data like the operating system or business environment, then just put it directly in our online storage. Put it on the server's hard drive. We mentioned earlier like some transaction data or log data or backup data. We might put it in an offline environment. A popular technology now is called SDS, called Software Defined Storage. We will mention it in the second chapter. We will elaborate on it in the future. So SDS actually, it's based on the owner. Based on the SEC, including based on admin, including based on user, their needs for data. You can first define a storage strategy. What is it like? What kind of data? Where do I put it? Whether to do the corresponding processing, for example, encryption or backup. Then use the automated processing method of this software. It's like after I define the strategy, I issue this business instruction, issue it to the SDS system. In the software defined storage system, then it will be based on the classification of data, will dynamically implement the corresponding. For example, location including related processing, this is all fully automated. In this way, first, it's more compliant. It's fully automated, it's not man-made, it's rule-based. Then secondly, the processing efficiency is relatively high. Otherwise, every time I get to a data, I have to redefine it myself and need to operate the data myself. And in the middle process, there may be some fraudulent situations. That's a lot of trouble. So SDS is widely used now. It's also an important tool for implementing data secure storage. Let's take a look in the preservation strategy. For example, classification. We just mentioned your data level. That data level, it defines your preservation time. That is how long you store. And the method of destruction in addition, including business needs. We have this preservation strategy. The location of preservation, including training for employees. We need to tell employees how to preserve, and in the whole process, the method of data preservation. This all needs to be. In addition, we need to review periodically the situation of the policy designation, including some data. Maybe its classification needs to be adjusted. That will affect the later preservation location and some of the preservation tools or changes in the implementation method. So this needs to be reassessed continuously. The risk of preservation. Let's summarize finally. Actually, from the perspective of data preservation, one is the business needs, one is the location of preservation, and another is the method of preservation and the time of preservation. These are the things. Of course, the most important thing is we need to meet the needs of the relevant parties. Including another is compliance, legal compliance. Every country actually has corresponding requirements and laws and regulations for data preservation. Our country issued the data security law in 2021 and the personal information protection law after that. The requirements for this are more detailed. Previously, there was already the national secrecy law. Our country's data is divided into top secret data, confidential data, and secret data. So there is already a considerable layering of data. This different levels of data, its preservation requirements and preservation cycle are definitely not the same. For example, top secret data is required to be 30 years. So different data, its preservation method and location are different.